we are going to Kennedy Space Center. All right. Holidays in space. Sunday, everybody. We are at Kennedy Space Center. We're gonna go have some fun. Holidays in space. Look at the meatball. Looks like a giant Christmas ornament. That is so awesome. I love that they do that. Welcome to Holidays in Space. So we made it through security. By the way, you do have to go through a metal detector when you come in here. This is actually all under construction. So in the grand scheme of theme parks and themed walls lately, here you go. So they're kind of building the Astronaut Hall of Fame over here on site. This is what I love about coming to Kennedy Space Center Visitors Complex. There's no other place in the world that when you walk through the door or the gate, you get to see a rocket garden. That's just amazing. I love that they put some Christmas decorations all around the rocket garden this year. You got that Christmas tree up there too. So you notice in the background there's two towers here, kind of like AV towers with lights or projection. That's going to project onto the Apollo rocket later on, and I'll have a Christmas show out here. Holidays in space. It's the International Space Station with candles in the field. I like that. I love this shirt. Oxygen, magnesium, OMG. I love this shirt too. So cool. So, by the way, I've seen folks talk about this at Magic Kingdom, and obviously, we have one here at Kennedy Space Center as well. There goes the Andromeda Galaxy. We're gonna go check out Space Shuttle Atlantis again. Why? Because it's freaking awesome. And they put a little bow on top of the Space Shuttle Atlantis sign. That's neat. No matter how many times that we see this movie, I get emotional every time. Telescope. Jesse's learning about satellites. You can dock the space shuttle to space station here. I love that there's actual parts of the ship here too. So this is the payload bay door tube cutter. You just gotta wonder like how they decided to design that. Pretty cool. I look at it and think of a Klingon warbird with at the front of the ship and the back just missing the wings. So good news if you're traveling and you're looking for a faster way to get here from the UK to Orlando or Orlando back to the UK, you can make it here in a space shuttle just under 15 minutes. I never get tired of just looking at the sheer magnitude of how big these engine pieces are. And if you can see all these little crevices that are in the back or the bottom of the space shuttle, that's debris from the pad as it took off from all of its missions. It's pretty crazy. So they've added an Ask an Expert section here. like tiles from the shuttle and blankets from the shuttle and so forth, and an expert that explains all the pieces.
But this one, the job of this blanket, it takes us so long to do, but it's so extremely important. Because when the external chain kicks up, we use explosive bolts, and if one of them goes the wrong direction, the one time we did have it in 2006, the job of this blanket is to catch the bolt so it doesn't damage the underside of the blanket. So we joke, 5-day blanket to make, and its job is done in 8 minutes. But it's an extremely important blanket. But this is the thread that I'm using. This right here, you want to see this one. This thread melts at 3,250 degrees. That's the thread that I'm using in that picture right there. And also to sew all the thermal barriers. They're all stitched with that thread right there. That's a hamburger patty. This is some of the examples of the food where you can pick up anything you want to. What we'll do is they have a gun of hot water with a hole that they'll check in the top of this and use Velcro, and they'll Velcro it to the wall of their kitchen. Or we have a small convection oven on board too. It takes about 10 to 12 minutes for it to cook. Then they just slit it open. But with the same Velcro on the back, they have Velcro on their arms and legs to Velcro it on so it doesn't float around. But they do, it's kind of interesting. They do a U-shaped cut on it. They think of everything. We do a U-shaped cut when they eat the food. Because it actually causes enough static to keep it down. And they cut it straight, the food would move. So they learn they cut it in a, like a smile, making it upside down, a frown. It actually keeps the food there. But there's over 4,000 food choices, and we have so many different ethnicities and countries that do that. They have about a year and a half would meet with the food team, and they could pick whatever food they wanted. We could convert. We started flying tortillas. We had our first Hispanic astronaut, probably now close to 27 years ago, abnormal size. We never, feel, that's heavy. That's what we call our tuffy tile. That type of tile would be backed by the engines. That's a thin one for an engine tile. Most of our tuffy tiles are 5 inches thick, but you see, that's pretty heavy compared to this one. This is 22 pounder, we call them 22 pounders. This is a 9 pounder. Not that they weigh 9 pounds, that's per cubic foot density. This one is probably about, I would say, 90% air and 10% pure silica sand. This one's probably closer to 80% air. You see how light they are? This one can do, at this thickness, probably close to about, 3,000 degrees. This one's about a 2,800 watt. We can take them out of the oven, and we used to play games with people who come into our building. We bake them at 2,100 degrees, and they're bright red on the inside. In fact, you'll want to go on YouTube. We have some really cool videos on seeing tiles being made. We can pick them out. They're red in the middle, but as long as we pick them up, actually this way on the corners, they're warm, and we can pick them up as soon as we take them out of the oven.
This is new since the last time we've been here. This is the Webb Space Telescope.
Following you.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
Looks like a bee. Of course I'm getting, because what happens when you stand in the sun too long? You get burned. That's why we oil protection. Now, have you ever seen a bottle similar to this?
Yeah, like
it has your medication in it. And the pharmacists use it because this color does not let UV light into the medicine to ruin the potency of the drug. I don't have medicine in here, but I did put UV beads in. What color are they? Okay, we're going to do an experiment with the black light. But what I'm going to need you to do is help me. So what we're going to do is I'm going to put this on, and we're going to count down from 10 to 0. Ready to count down?
Yep.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh my.
That's pretty crazy.
So what I'm going to do is there's different lights in here, so I'm just going to keep it covered. I have Sprite. Now, I used it yesterday, but it's still got carbonation in it, and tonic water. And the light is purple. Okay, I'm agreeing with that it is. So we're going to take the regular water, and we're going to see if it changes the water. Not really. But maybe the Sprite with the carbonated bubbles will change it. Should we see? No, not really. Now the tonic water tastes bitter, and that's why a lot of adults put an additional beverage inside. To me, but it does have a chemical that's a harmless chemical called quinine.
Oh my!
Isn't that beautiful? You can see
Does it have like salt in it also? Or?
Well, it's quinine, which is a chemical, and that's what makes it bitter.
Okay.
This mannequin is disguised as a Christmas tree. I think we might have to get this. It's Santa on a space shuttle.
Yeah.
Or he's holding a space shuttle, but I like him riding it.
I like him riding it too.
I don't remember them having these signs before, but it kind of adds to the mystique of where the bus tours take you, which I personally love. If you come to the Space Center, you need to take the bus tour, go along all of the pads where they formerly had rockets. They may even have a rocket out there for you to see. And all of the history that you learn.
Rocket, same type of rocket that put the first American into space. Alan Shepard, May 5th, 1961. Look underneath the bottom, you'll see a red deflector plate that's called the flame deflector. The shuttle has a flame trench, 58 feet wide, 42 feet deep, 450 feet long. You have to be 3.5 miles away from that, or you will die. Now look, if you look up in the trees on the limbs and stuff, you may see the eagles. Now when I got hired here about 6 months ago, it had eaglets and it's the little babies, and they don't get white heads for 4 to 5 years. You'll see it's the highest tree out there, tallest tree out there behind the power lines, and you'll see, you come down a quarter of the way and you'll see a big black mass, and it's really, really, really big. And when you come back on the other side, we'll talk about it more. That's 50 years old. There's 9 active eagles nests. In the 1960s, our President John F. Kennedy came to the world and said, we were going to the moon. We had a giant Saturn V rocket, which you're going to see, that used so much fuel that we had to have a safety zone of 3.5 miles. So we went to Cape Canaveral, tried to get some real estate, but we couldn't get any real estate there. So we came here. We got 140,000 acres. Now pay attention, and since December 1968, every manned mission that's left the United States has launched from 39 A and B. Normally on the full tour, you go to A and B, but because of the launch tonight, they're not allowing us to do that. So pay attention to this building in front of me, very important, VAB, Vehicle Assembly Building. All the rockets and shuttles were assembled in that building by workers, but they used a tool called the crawler transporter, which you're going to get to see. There's a tractor on the bottom and a mobile platform on the top, right? So the tractor would drive the platform into the building where workers would either assemble a rocket or a shuttle, take it out to the pad site, A or B, leave it, let it launch. Once it launched, it would go back and retrieve it, take it back into the vehicle assembly building and start that process all over again.
NASA to reach its goal of human
exploration. One of the doors of the VAB building is up top. As you can see, inside the door,
the large tower,
all of those garage doors kind of slide open to pull stuff in and out.
That's brand new. It's the new mobile launcher.
It will carry.
But if you look directly in front of me, you'll see this orange line. That's called the towway line. That's where all 135 shuttles came down the tire on that main orange line because of a 78-foot wingspan. I told you about the crawler transporter. If you look directly in front of me, that's what you're looking at, the crawler transporter. It doesn't have the taxi underneath of it. It sits on pedestals. Now, there is rabbit ear looking things. They're called the tail service mast. The shuttle, when they would take that into the vehicle assembly building, the shuttle would be mounted to that platform, and those things that have little hats on them, They're called rainbirds. Water comes out of those. They also would have the rocket boosters and the external tanks assembled on top of that crawler transporter. These are the largest self-tracked vehicles in the world. There's only two of them here, and they're both, but there's only two of them in the world, and they're both here at the Kennedy Space Center, okay? They were made in Marion, Ohio by the Marion Power Shovel Company, sent here in segments and assembled on site, okay? So these things are humongous. The size of the top is about the size of a baseball infield, okay? This is called a crawler transporter. There's only two of them, okay? Now, when you look underneath here, you're gonna see three holes. Two for the rocket boosters in the back. The one up front there, that's for the main engine. You've seen it on TV when you see the three main engines. That's where all the flames shoot down into the flame trench. It's really cool. That flame trench I told you about is 58 feet wide, 42 feet deep, 450 feet long. This big gray tank you're looking at right here, right? They put water in that to level out the crawler transporter because of all the uneven weight. But the tractor that carries that actually has hydraulics, which keeps it all level when it goes up onto the pad site. Now this one in front of me, this is brand new, the new mobile launcher for the SLS, the Space Launch System, 384-foot rocket. She holds up to 9 school buses. That's called the umbilical tower. Inside is communications, fuel, and electric, and plus electronics. Plus it has an elevator for the astronaut to get to the top of the rocket. If you notice underneath, there's only one hole, or one square, rectangular, because it's only one solid rocket. They're getting this ready for 2017, where the tractor will pick it up, move the pedestals, pick it up, take it into the vehicle assembly building, where they will assemble that SLS, the Space Launch System, on top of that. In 2018, she'll have the Orion hooked to her, and she's gonna take off. She'll be unmanned, top layer being Tennessee River rock, which flows in the Tennessee River, but they get it in Alabama, because the Tennessee River flows through Alabama. So anyway, it acts as ball bearings and cushions the ride of the tractor and the crawler transporter, because together they weigh 6 million pounds and carry 3 times that amount of weight. So over 26 million pounds she can carry. So when she's fully loaded, she runs 1 mile per hour. When she races back the tractor, she races back at 2 miles per hour. Every 32 feet, she uses a gallon of diesel. Every mile, she uses 150 gallons of diesel. So when you compare her to your SUV, you got a great vehicle. That thing sucks up a lot of fuel. They let the tracks on there, they have to regrade it every time. Normally I say this way out there, but I have to say it now because you're seeing it. Now, if you don't believe that that's the tallest single-story building in the world, just look at the little door on the bottom. It looks like our little mouse hole. We can't scale it up against anything. The doors are so little. And those doors that are, there's two on this side, two on the other side, they're 456 feet high. The tallest doors in the world. When you knock on the door, it takes 45 minutes for them to fully open. Once they fully open, you can actually slide the Statue of Liberty through there easily with the pedestal and everything and have 150 feet of clearance left over. That's how big that building is inside. She is huge. 2018, she'll be hooked to the Orion. Now, if something happens, and there were astronauts inside, that would yank it off the capsule, take it a mile out, and land safely. That way, none of our astronauts die. Now, this is the most important building in all of Kennedy Space Center, with the blue tarp on top. Can any, many, many important decisions made in that building. Can anybody tell me what it is?
Cafeteria.
Darn straight. The cafeteria. You talk about the president, Elon Musk, all the astronauts. Of course, we don't get to go there because we don't have clearance. You don't have clearance, remember? So that's a bummer, but yeah, that's the cafeteria. Of course, everybody goes there that has the clearance.
We've gone back in time now to check out a launch of the Apollo mission. Check this out.
This is the firing room, launch control for the Apollo mission. This is not a mocker. These are the very consoles we sat at when men first took off to fly to the moon. The tragedy of Apollo 1 put us a year and a half behind. We were making up for it in one big leap, and we were doing it with a rocket that no man had ever flown before.
Within the last vehicle. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
jam as we come out. You can see the rockets of the Saturn V here. I like walking right underneath this rocket. Put a bed right here. I'd like to have a bed there. Maybe a couch.
What?
Watch some TV with a rocket right on top of us. Oh. If you go through the doors where the Saturn V rocket is, you come out to these bleachers, which are used typically when they have launches taking place on the launch pads 39A or 39B. And what you can see here is one of the launch pads down that way. And we see the vehicle assembly building and the crawler that we were just talking about on the bus tour. I'm just gonna pan the horizon here. See what's out here at the launch pads. There you go. So they have a cutaway of what the Saturn V looks like on the inside as well. As you can see through the different stages. So inside of the Saturn V building, they've added experts now as well. So if you guys come to visit and you have questions on any of the equipment, they're here to answer them. Check this out. This is absolutely nuts, the rate of speed that this lunar lander comes down. I'm going to give you perspective. Dun, da, da. There's a mock-up one. That thing, traveling that fast. The tree is all lit up now. What contrast with everything in the background. Check it out in the rocket garden. They have like snowflakes on the rockets. That's so cool. And even over here, you see on the big Saturn V, everything kind of already projected on there. And you got a projection on that building back there for Holidays in Space. So kind of the calm before the show. That's looking really gorgeous. Look at these guys all lit up. The Christmas tree. You're not gonna see anything like this anywhere else. goodbye Kennedy Space Center again. If you're coming to Florida, this is such a unique place to visit. Always an amazing time. Look at that, that is so cool. So of note, one of the reasons why we came out here today was because there was going to be a launch of a rocket at nighttime. It didn't happen, it got scrapped. We're gonna try it again tomorrow night, which is what always happens, or it could happen if you're coming out to the Space Center for a specific launch, and you never know if it's actually gonna happen or not. So no big loss for us, we had an awesome day anyway, but just one thing of note, in case you are planning to come out here to witness a launch. Hey, we're back home from Kennedy Space Center. That was a really fun day, unexpected day. We only headed out there this morning after hearing that they would have a potential rocket launch. We had planned to try to get to Busch Gardens this weekend. Yesterday, I think we went a little long with the mail vlog, and then afterwards realized we needed to do more shopping and things that we needed to do around the house, and pushed off Busch Gardens to today, and it didn't happen. So if we get to Christmastown, it'll probably be after Christmas. If we don't, we went there last year at least. But I thought the better spend of time would be over at Kennedy Space Center. So that's the way it goes. But for now, we're going to log off. So thank you for all of your likes. Thank you for your comments. Thank you for your subscriptions. Treat others the way you want to be treated. Have a great night. We'll see you guys.